So you go for the network renderer. I like your computer to do the heavy work. Where the various network players are basically all the same, save the storage and ripping hardware, the network renderer misses out on all that hardware plus the logic electronics. It has to be controlled from a dedicated server software that runs on a computer elsewhere in the house. The famous Squeezebox system works like this. Recently, Rune Labs announced endpoints that work like this. In case of the Squeezebox, the renderer contained an infrared receiver that caught a signal from an infrared remote and sent it over the network to the server software that responded by sending audio bits to the Squeezebox. Later, a sophisticated remote and an app for smartphones and tablets became available. Rune Labs works only on tablets since the user interface needs a bigger screen. Let's analyze the name I gave to this kind of devices. It has a network interface and or Wi-Fi card for connecting to the controller software on the computer and to the tablet or smartphone. It gets digital music sent to it by control software on a computer elsewhere in the network. So it's more or less a dumb device that only receives digital audio over the network and converts it to analog. Since this device is not able to rip or store music, it has to be done on a separate device, usually a computer. I will do a separate video on ripping and on adding metadata, but I must mention here that not all CDs are always ripped and labeled correctly. There can be several reasons why a CD isn't ripped properly, like scratches, dirt, or just a bad pressing. Even when the ripping went perfect, the metadata might not be found or be correct. Sometimes the ripping software on your computer will prompt you to choose from a number of alternatives. Sometimes it will automatically add wrong metadata or just add no metadata at all. Then you end up with an entry called unrecognized title that holds track 1, track 2, and so on. You can correct this by using special naming programs on the computer, as for instance Rename for Windows, MusicBrainz Picard for Windows and Mac, or Yeat for the Mac. A lot has been said about the quality of equipment that works with computer technology. Music from a hard disk could never sound as good as a CD. Therefore, I'll repeat it again. Chances that a hard disk reads the audio bits with far more accuracy than a CD are extremely high. It's more about the noisy electronics inside normal computers. But that's a matter of having the right design goal. As I have mentioned before, a CD player is a computer too, as is the washing machine, the TV, and the car. It's not the computer components that might make a player sound bad. It's the technical design. It might be clear that the technical design depends on the budget available. Therefore, a well-designed player costing 2,500 euros will sound better than a well-designed player costing 1,000 euros. And, as always, a badly designed 2,500 euros player might sound worse than a 1,000 euro player. It might be clear that the network renderer is the cheapest solution in the market since a lot of the work is done by the computer, including the logic. Since the renderer has to be placed close to the stereo, it needs to be quiet. Since it doesn't contain a hard disk and therefore doesn't need a big power supply, fans are usually not needed. Therefore, the player can be placed in the living without a fear for noise. If you're held back by the idea of ripping large quantities of CDs, it's good to know there are companies that offer that service. The going price is about 1 euro a disc, somewhat lower for larger orders and well negotiable for really big orders. You often have to take all your CDs out of their jewel cases or sleeves and put them on a spindle, since the company loads them into a fully automatic ripping machine. Make sure you specify full CD quality as output format, FLAC, ALAC or AIF. WAV is also full CD quality but has limited metadata capabilities and therefore is the lesser choice. All four formats contain exactly the same audio data and should not sound different from each other. If there is a difference in sound, it's because your equipment, i.e. the player, works better with some formats and worse with others. This is not likely to occur these days, but has been an item with some British players a number of years ago. Recently, internet streaming services started offering full CD quality streaming. Big names here are Tidal and Qobuz, and both even announced streaming at higher quality using MQA technology. For CD quality, any player that supports Tidal and Qobuz will do. To use high-res music, you will need an MQA compatible DA converter. Now, you don't need to rip your CDs, which might save you a lot of money when you have it done by others. Nor do you need a shared volume on a computer or NAS, which with large collections might cost you, since you do need to back up everything or take the chance of having to rip it all again, which you don't really want. If you love music and like the convenience of choosing music from your armchair and have a computer running in your network, the network renderer might be a good and cheap solution for you. Or use it for playing music from quality streaming services like Tidal or Qobuz, provided it will support these services. If you like even better than CD quality, you might want an MQA compatible device, for both Tidal and Qobuz just started streaming in this format. Developments go quick, like the new MQA format, so if you want to remain informed, subscribe to this channel, follow my Facebook or Google Plus page, or my Twitter account. You can also post questions there. You'll find the information below this video in YouTube. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and tell your friends on the web about it. I am Hans Beekhuizen for the HB channel. Thank you for watching and see you on the next show or on the hbproject.com. And whatever you do, enjoy the music.